What's up, young world? It's the OG Sim Sensation, making simming cool throughout the nation. Sim a little, sip a little, watching flowers grow. You may think you do, but you'll never truly know who's behind the mask yet. Eight Sims to go to college. You know what I'm saying? Let me show you these peoples that I created to go to college. Where they live now? Okay, I done created a whole world for her. I'm gonna get to it. So I created these. No, they don't live here. Oh, I put them all in Newcrest. Created a world for them. So I created these people to go to college. Eight people. The Steins. And the Steins, you know, they came from money. Because I made eight. And I let the machine, they got this new little feature. Y'all simming along with me. Because if you a simmer and I'm a simmer, we got something in common, baby. And we going to get along just fine. Y'all can come back and visit me anytime you want. I'm going to be here. I'll be here waiting on you. So, I just do gameplay, y'all. I am really not trying to build nothing. If y'all built something and I'm using it, thank you. Mama is going through the balls. So I am hot right now. I am flashing as we speak, child.
Flashing. Lights.
But, yeah. I'm not gonna remember your name. If I'm sitting right there using it and I read it, and if you read your name, thank you and know I'm giving you mad love and shout out. If you see your stuff, thank you and know I'm giving you mad love. I'm gonna give a shout out to one of my favorite simmers, but I don't know her name. Key something. She know who she is. She crazy like me, y'all. But yeah, she is an inspiration. Let me see if I can find her. So, just want to say, hey, girl, if you want to influence with me, let's share some sim stories. So, yeah, key something, y'all. Kia, baby, Kia. I don't know. I think that might be it. But hey, baby. Excuse me. So I put these people, eight people, fresh, brand new baby Sims. Like I said, the Steins. I gave them a backstory, put them in college. They came from, you know, world outside of this world. And the brightest and most talented, the Steins, they're biracial, black mother, Jewish father. And they come from money. And that's because the first Stein that I created, the girl, was the computer generated, and the computer gave her money, made her come out wealthy. So surprise, surprise, this bitch the only one went to college and got an A at the University of Bright Chester. So out of all eight of these motherfuckers, one girl got an A. Two of these motherfuckers still in school. Let me show you their asses. They couldn't even get their asses out. These two, now the one in the middle, she is dying. She did get to graduate. She got a nice little cute job. You know, she making a little money. She got a little signing bonus. You know, but the two on the ends, they married. They still in college, y'all. These two motherfuckers, I couldn't even get them out. They still taking one class, two class. And that's real, y'all, because it was motherfuckers that I went on the damn 15-year plan, 7-year plan at least and shit. So out of the eight, one girl got A's, and she graduated and got a really good job. And I think she is, let's see, where's she at? Let me find her. Y'all, I don't know where the child at. When we run into her, I'll tell you, that's her. That's her right there. There she is right there. I done grew her hair out. The one in the middle. So she ain't at home right now. She at her She is Princess Leia. She is an intergalactic bitch. So I learned a lesson, you know, and what maybe learned it really, really badly was that her ass decided she wanted to go to college and pick up a violin. And you know, when they first started playing the violin, they sound like a cat in a damn hot tin roof, screeching, crying, carrying on. So she thinks she doing it, y'all. She like, playing that damn violin. And here come a prodigy. Some dude, he on scholarship. He's an aficionado or some shit. He playing that damn violin like he damn made the motherfucker. Now his name is Strauss. What's the damn fancy damn violin? I don't know what the damn violin is. It's called mandolin. I don't fucking know. He played this shit like he fucking made it, created it. So he just, that poor child got so embarrassed. She just was yellow all over, just embarrassed. And so she turned to walk away and go hide in the bed. And here come another girl. And she got the violin. I mean, she got the guitar. And this girl was playing this guitar. She was playing songs on that guitar. I didn't even know the Sims had friggin' rights to. This bitch was so cold on the guitar. And they was both letting my bitch know, bitch, you came to fucking college with no skills, no nothing, no talent. You just came on ass. So you lucky you rich. Because, bitch, you the only one getting A's with your non-violin playing ass. So, hint number one, y'all. Y'all got to have some rich sense to get them up in there in them good schools. That like the real world. Just like the real world. It don't hurt if you give bribes. If you volunteer. If you are a celebrity. So come find out. I'm looking at the Sims challenges. I done a challenge, y'all. Congratulations to me, baby. I done myself a hard ass university challenge, y'all. I got them motherfuckers out. But I realized that I really enjoyed the excitement of getting my letter, you know, growing up and then going off to college. So I want to do that for these people. So I decided I'll take them. I saw that each of them, you know, the ones that didn't fail out got C's. So they got decent jobs and decent salaries, you know. But I want to see what happens if I raise them from babies and then send them off to college. You know, see what kind of life, you know, choices open up for them after that. So when I start thinking about that, I was like, oh, shit, that's fun. Yeah, let me do that. Let me do that. So anyway, I gave them 5 kids. And I'm like, okay, let me have these people that all got these scholarships from the Stein Scholarship. Have kids, and second generation of Stein scholarships will be, you know, like second generation always is, a little bit better than the first. So that's introducing you to all these people. These are the surviving members of the original 8 at college, except that Mordecai guy or whatever his damn name is, Morpheus, with the red jacket on. He, I don't know what it is. I think it's a celebrity or something. I got him off the up there called? Up in the right-hand corner. Come on, y'all. What is it called? The gallery. Got his ass off the gallery, but maybe in my library. Maybe, like, he's somebody that EA gave me. And, you know, he just gives me, like, the feelings like he want to be an evil magician. Oh, shit. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, he want to be like, ha, 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 and put his little pinky to his mouth. So I went ahead and let him hook up with Lilith, because, I mean, Lilith is her name, so clearly she want to be an evil witch. What's up? I don't know what the bitch want to be. I just went with what the traditional Lilith mythology say. She want to be free. you want to be free to ease of mind. Okay, so that's the backstory now. Them two sisters, Nessus, I don't know what they names is. Y'all know Lilith and her sister, her. So, dude, he went on ahead and married one of them because when they was all in college, that's all would talk to his nerdy self. Like, the dude here, the next dude, he is a clown, y'all. He is hilariously a clown. He a doctor, though. He got his ass out of college. He got C's, but the nigga is this guy. He's a doctor. The white girl, the only one would be bothered with his ass. I swear to you not. All the cute black girls was like, even the side girl was like, honey, no thank you. Daddy has money. My real daddy. Don't need his ass. So, yeah. When that is just like in life. Y'all be mad when white girls be taking our men. But it always be a nigga y'all would not have fucked with yourself. And you know it. Y'all be like, ugh, he corny. He go to school. He just sees. Y'all ain't thinking, ain't nobody gonna ask a nigga at the doctor office, what did you get in school? What, be honest, which one of y'all has ever gone to the doctor office and said, what kind of grades did you get in school? Can I get an amen? I've thought in my mind, but I've never asked the doctor, did you get good grades in school? Yeah, no. I just was like, you graduated, right? Because, for real, them motherfuckers be, if they a surgeon, most of them got the book open, y'all. If y'all better watch that commercial. Okay, it's not okay, boo. Okay, it's not okay. But they be having surgeries with the book open. Mm-hmm. And sometimes they be like, you know, looking on the internet and shit. I know y'all laughing, but y'all know it better be on YouTube and heart surgery and shit. Brain surgery. Yeah. So, yeah, that bitch, she said, I'll take him. So I said, okay, let these people do what they do, babe, because this is what the world is about, honey. Let a man that fucking love who he loves. As long as you ain't loving on mine, who I love, then I'm fine. Okay. Now, these two. She was like, I fuck with you. He really, really had been liking her. Not boyfriend in the front at all. Not pink pants. Not my baby pink pants. Not him. The one in the back. Now, he looked like a, you know, not a bum. Y'all cut it out. A grunge? I don't know what kind of thing that wear that, but my husband would wear that, but that's what I like, you know what I'm saying? Chill, that thing he got on. You don't have one, but if you had one, you would wear it, wouldn't you? You wouldn't wear that? Oh, good, because I didn't want to. No, he ain't never worn nothing like that, y'all, and I ain't never asked him to, but I was thinking if he had one, he might. But I ain't never seen nothing like that in his clothes. I ain't never put nothing like that. I wear something like that. I got that, don't I? But yeah, he wears dashikis. There's a difference. So, she was like, okay. But he had been liking her for so long. And he's probably an engineer. And the dude, P-Bass, he just had a nice house. And he was like, y'all come live with me. I love you, girl. You my girl. He just wanted to be Uncle Pink Pants. That is all he wanted to do with his life. Now, another thing I love about this game. There are some things that I could do on this game that I wouldn't do in real life. Like, murder people. Ooh, did I say that? You be thinking, don't act like y'all don't be thinking y'all will murder somebody. Don't act like y'all don't be thinking that. Well, I'm just let you know. Sims be murdering people, y'all. So, I definitely added some challenges. Now, this is going to be my first time murdering people. It is going to be hard. Because I tried to see some of these games I practiced so that I wouldn't be looking crazy when I got to playing with y'all. And I figured we could just make some of the rules up as we go along and some of the challenges that I've chosen to play. are definitely going to be tailored to my specificities. So I was talking about using different mods. Not mods. Shit, that's my gameplay on. I wish. Don't you guys? Oh my gosh. Now, I did get this Isaac Mizrahi, because that's kind of, you know, as close as we can get to mods on friggin' consoles. But mods make the game so lovely. Kind of how my husband likes to use the cheats. I'm trying to get that nigga to share his gameplay with y'all. As they say, the family that what plays together does what stays together and what prays together and what slays together, baby. I am not going to be using their little, you know, challenge as to a tier. I'm definitely going to be changing them up to suit my needs, making some up as I go as well. And if y'all got some and y'all want to put them down there on the comment section, get your heads out the gutter, put them in the comment section, and if I like them, I will play them. And you know, put your houses and all your people in there too. I like gameplay, you know. My son was like, "Mom, you're not a sinner if you're not creating." I said, "No, I am not a creator if I am not creating." Hello! This is a difference. And baby, you keep on being a creator. That's the next generation. That's what I'm trying to tell y'all. Yeah, I got a little coding. Like, you like to play them, but you need to be creating them, because that is where the money is. And he good, y'all. Yeah, show him love every year. So, thank you, Jesus, on that. I be going listening to them creators talk. So, you know, working on getting them into some of them programs. They keep inviting them to participate in different summer programs for gifted and intelligent. When I was coming up, gifted didn't mean what it means now, y'all. So, you know, thank you, Jesus. But, yeah. I'm going to be like, she gifted, y'all. She gifted. She just gifted. But not mean something different, y'all. So, anyway. So, I have this whole world that I decided I would just create a world around all the different challenges that I wanted to play. And, you know, I want these babies right here. These 14 babies right here. To grow up with some people that I kind of liked and wanted to play. So, you know, let's take it from here. I populated the earth. You know, I kept the names the same. You know, but I moved some. Let's say load up some color in. You know, I wanted a melting pot of a world. And I made everyone have children so that they'll all be matriculating at the same time, hopefully. So, you know, I made them at different ages. I didn't do the let the people in the world, you know, age. I did let them age only when I'm playing them, because that's the way I like it. So I made people of all ages, you know. And I don't use cheats because I'm a purist. I think it makes it fun. No. Whatever, dude. Some people think that's funny. So, shout out to Heaven's Care Estate. I'm using it. Now, I told y'all, I looked her name up. It is Kia. I confirm. It's Kia, right, baby? She is fun and definitely one of my children. And honestly, one of my mentors, too, because I definitely enjoyed watching her. She gave me the confidence to say, okay, I can just be myself, and people follow her, is it, yeah, It's Kia. Kia. So, this is a shout out to her. She, what I watched was an adoption challenge that I'm going to follow of hers. Because I really liked the concept of, you know, when I mean, looking up the babies too. I always adopt some children, you know, in my families. So just the thought of having a challenge where it was filled with kids that needed a home, you know, and then helping them find one, even if it's not in the, in, you know, the world I'm playing, because I'm filled to capacity. I don't know what's going to happen. They got the dang on exclamation point. So many people gonna die. So yeah, you know, I wanted to have all nationalities and, you know, all the peoples represented, you know. Now why, come on now. Now this one of the, I got that family from somebody in the Sims world. Every time I go there, that baby ain't got no clothes on but that pamper. Now y'all know better. Y'all know better. But I don't know, child. I can't be sure because I've been seeing some houses when the baby just be running around with a full pamper. Now these dusty people, this is really ridiculous. So I just went on ahead and named his butt Ash. Because, you know, and the baby Ashy. Ash and Ashy. Because y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. I don't know. They came like that. I just left it. Like, fuck it. Let them be Ash and Ashy. These people look nice. Thank you. But then, you know, kind of live in the hood. Gotta get them out of the hood. Okay, the chicken. And then the Kennys. The Carries. The Spencer comes in. So, because I'm a purist, the town is going to have to buy all of these places so that our celebrities can work out of them, because, I mean, let's be honest, it's just the way of the world. So, don't act like y'all didn't vote for a celebrity. Yeah, somebody did. Celebrities in office. Savant Cuckoo Clocks, that's, you know, the asylum challenge I want to do. So celebrities got to buy that, and one of them got to run it. And that's how they get money for it. They get the celebrities, and the celebrities do the yuck-yucking, and the money come rolling in. Honey, that's the way of the world. And then, you know, it's kind of like finishing school, but it's just hoes into housewives, y'all.
Gone are my blues, and gone are my tears. I've got good news to shout in your ears. The long lost dollar has come back to the fold. With silver you can turn your dreams to gold. Oh, we're in the money, we're in the money. We've got a lot of what it takes to get along. We're in the money, the sky is sunny. Oh man, depression, you are through, you done us wrong. Oh, we never see headline above red line today. And when we see the landlord, we can look that guy right in the eye. Oh, we're in the money. Come on, my honey. Let's land it, spend it, send it rolling around.
We're in the money. I said we're in the money. We got a lot of what it takes to get along. So we're in the money. Look up, the skies are stunning. Old man, you mentioned you want to do us wrong. We never see a headline, a red line today.
Thank you.
guys. Somebody got to do it. Somebody got to turn them hoes into housewives. You can still be a hoe. Just be a hoe for your husband. That's what I'm trying to say. That's all I'm trying to say. Get these hoes married off. And this is my favorite family of the Happy Lunar New Year, the year of the rat. It's my baby. My baby's a rat. Yes, go Disney. The year of the rat. I never go here. So, you know, I'm going to have new rules for this world. I'm going to get out. If somebody say, come on, let's go. I don't care where I am, what I'm doing. I got to stop and go. And that is such a pain. I know it's going to be a pain because you know every 5 minutes somebody, right when you're in the middle of doing something really important, here come, hey, it's the Spice Festival. I want to go to the Spice Festival. You're like, motherfucker, did I ask you to call me? Ask me on the day of Spice? I'm trying to do something here. They can quit calling me about some damn Spice Festival. No, I don't want to go to the Spice Festival. But this time around, it is mandatory. If somebody call and invite you to go somewhere, go. Because that's one thing I learned about playing university was that, you know, I joined the secret society, y'all. It's a secret. And then I got these sprites following me around. And at first I was like, these sprites just getting on my dang on nerves. But then I realized that they were helping to increase my Sims. Like, one of my Sims got married fucking around with them sprites. She had to do them romantic, you know, socials. She's romanced herself into a proposal, honey. I bullshit you not. So I'm just gonna go. If they say I need to go to the Spice Festival, clearly I ain't got no spices. I never have spices. I wonder why. I'm grown up. I take too much time out my clock. I be having shit to do, boo. I be having places to go. Challenges to meet. So I ain't never been in none of these places. Like, I think when they first popped up on my game, this is new. I don't know where she came from. Villa Bovine. I just left today. I guess we'll go out to dinner one of these days. I guess we go grocery shopping. Now, I saw some of the nice, honey, I saw a Walmart. I saw a Walmart. You guys are just so incredibly talented. I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of you. Thank you for being my Sims.
This has been a Sim-itation of life.
You ain't going to law, Craig.